He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Okay guys, for today's problem, we have a compound here and we're going to want to do two things. Number one, we want to be able to draw the Newman projection of going down this bond in this direction here as is marked. And number two, we want to be able to name this molecule, including stereochemistry. So if any of this is confusing, you're going to want to check out my tutorials on Newman projections, as well as nomenclature and cahn-ingold-prelog convention, how to assign R and S. Okay, so the first thing we wanted to be able to do was to draw the Newman projection for down this bond right here. So I've drawn that here. Let's take a look at what's going on. Remember that when we draw Newman projections, we want to imagine ourselves in the plane of the board or the page. So I'm here, I'm in the board, and I'm looking at this molecule this way. That means that everything that is in the plane of the board is above or below me, or just right here in this plane, right? And then things that are on wedge and dash bonds, those are to the left or the right accordingly. So if I'm right here on this front carbon, remember that this front carbon is represented by this circle, and then the bond to the back carbon and the back carbon itself can't be seen. Those are behind that circle. And so if I'm right here, I'm looking up and I'm seeing an isopropyl group above me, directly above. So on the front carbon, here's that isopropyl. And then this hydroxyl group, that's on the wedge bond, that's out here, that's sticking out like that. So if I'm in the board, I see that down and to my left. So that's down to my left. And then the implied hydrogen, which would be on the dash bond, that's this way, that's past the board, so that's down and to my right, this way. Now on the back carbon, going down, we have a propyl group that's directly down from here. So there's the propyl group. On the dash bond, which is going this way, there's that ethyl group, so that is up and to my right, right there. And then the implied hydrogen, which would be on the wedge bond, that is going to be up and to my left. So there's the correct Newman projection for what we have drawn. Now we also want to be able to name this. So whenever we're going to name a molecule, the first thing we need to do is number the parent chain. And so for the hydroxyl group is the highest priority group on this molecule. So we need to number in such a way so as to give the hydroxyl occurring soonest. On this molecule, that is going to be right to left. So that is going to be our numbering scheme there. Because if we went left to right, the hydroxyl would be occurring later than if we went this way. And now we have to recognize what substituents are in the molecule. So clearly we have a methyl group on carbon 2, and we have an ethyl group on carbon 4. And those are going to be listed alphabetically. So E ethyl before M methyl. Let's go ahead and list the majority of this molecule. We know that this is going to be 4 ethyl, 2 methyl, and then the hydroxyl group is occurring on carbon 3, and this is a 7-carbon parent chain, so that is a heptanol. Okay, so that's the majority of it, but we're not quite done yet because we said we also want the stereochemistry. So let's see which carbons are chiral centers. Now, going from the right to the left, oftentimes we might be tempted to say that is a chiral center. A lot of times students will see just there's anything on a wedge or dash bond, so that's a chiral center. But we have to really examine it and say, are there 4 different groups projecting from this carbon? And here there are not, because these two methyl groups are identical. So this is not a stereocenter, which we could see if we just rotate around this bond, this carbon could be up here, that carbon would be down there, it would look different. So that is actually not a chiral center. Over here though, number 3, we do have a chiral center, and so we want to assess the priority of these groups. And so from here, we've got carbon, carbon, implied hydrogen, and oxygen. So let's draw in that implied hydrogen. So the implied hydrogen is clearly number 4. The oxygen is clearly number 1. Now let's look at these two carbons. Now these two carbons are identical, so we have to see what they are attached to. This carbon is attached to carbon, carbon, hydrogen, right? This one is attached to carbon, carbon, hydrogen on the wedge bond. So that actually is still a tie. So let's see what those are attached to. Well, this carbon is attached to hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. This one is hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. And then over here, this one is attached to one carbon, as well as this. So because these two carbons are both attached to one carbon, whereas these carbons are attached to all hydrogens, this one ends up taking priority. And so that is going to be number three. And so we do have priority four away from us. So we can look at this and go 1, 2, 3. That is R. So number three, carbon three is an R stereocenter. Now let's do the same. Let's do the same for this one here. So this one is actually attached to, we've got this implied hydrogen, which is going to be priority four. But then other than that, we have three carbon atoms that are all identical. Carbon, carbon, carbon. Well, let's see what they're attached to. Once again, this carbon is attached to an oxygen atom, which is heavier than any other atom on the molecule. So that is going to end up being priority one. This direction is priority one for that carbon. Now we look at these two carbons. This is attached to hydrogen, hydrogen, carbon. This is attached to hydrogen, hydrogen, carbon. So again, these two positions tie. Now we're over here. Now this carbon is attached to hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. This one is attached to hydrogen, hydrogen, carbon. So this one actually ends up winning. That's going to be number three. Number two. And then this one is going to be number three. Now, here we are in a situation where the lowest priority group is actually towards us. And so what we need to be able to do is one of two things, either view the molecule from the other side, which many students have difficulty with. So instead, let's do the trick that we mentioned. Let's pretend that the hydrogen is on the dash bond and the ethyl is on the wedge bond. So if the ethyl was on the wedge bond, we would simply go 1, 2, 3, like that, and we would say R. But because we inverted the stereochemistry to be able to view it that way, we must then invert our answer to reflect the actual molecule. So we will call that S. And so now the way we list the stereochemistry there is we simply say we have 3R, 4S, and then the rest of the molecule. So the complete name will be 3R, 4S, 4-ethyl, 2-methyl, 3-heptanol. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.